Hi children, good morning to you all. Today we are going to see an interesting topic called image editing in our lesson 3. So what is meant by image editing? The process of changing the size, color, contrast, shape, or even adding a text to an image is called image editing. So image editing can be done with a GIMP and MT Paint softwares. So in this lesson, we are going to see in detail about how to use Mark Taylor's Paint, which is also known as an MT Paint. So how to open an MT Paint is, just you have to click on the start icon, start menu, then we have to press the MT Paint icon and your MT Paint will be opened. And now we have to click file, in which is in the menu bar, then we have to click open option. So it will go directly into our folder, and from there we can select any picture which we want to edit and it will get opened in the MT Paint. So now we are getting into the editing process. So first we are going to learn about cropping. So what is cropping is? Cropping means the removal of specific portion from the picture. That is, if you are taking, for example, if you are taking photograph in any of the tourist places, when you are taking photograph, there will be some people who will also get into that image. Well, so now we have to remove those persons from that image. So for that, we can use this cropping function. So how to do that is, first we have to click make selection icon in the toolbar. That is, this is the toolbar, this is how your MT Paint screen will appear, and we have to first select the make selection icon. This is the selection icon which is present in the toolbar. Once you click that, a red color selection box appears like this. Using your mouse, we have to click which portion you want to be covered in the image. That is, the portion which appears within this red color selection box only will be retained after editing. The here in this image, if you see, means the left window and in right some part is not coming within the red color selection box, and after editing you see only that is retained. This is before editing, and now you see only that part will be edited. So after selecting this place where the image want to be edited, then you have to click image icon which is present in the menu bar. Image, first you have to click image, then you have to select crop function. Okay, now the image gets edited. So this is called cropping. Once again, you can see cropping means the removal of specific portion from a picture. So first we have to click the make selection icon in the toolbar, and we have to select the required portion of the image. Only the selected portion will be retained after editing. Okay, then we have to select image menu, then we have to choose the crop option. This is called cropping. Then we are going to see about scaling. What is scaling? Scaling means the size of the image is reduced without losing any part of the picture. So scaling is different from cropping. In cropping, the size of the image is reduced. That is, any of the portion in the image, we are editing that using cropping function. But in scaling, just we are reducing the size of the image. Just we are compressing the image. Suppose if the image is in some KB, we are reducing that image if the image is in 20 KB, and we can, using this option, we can reduce the image to 10 KB. So this can be done with scaling. Okay, so how to do that? From the image option on the menu bar, we have to select scale canvas option, and in the pop-up window, see here, from the image option in the menu bar, we have to select scale canvas. Then if you select scale canvas, then the scale canvas dialog pop-up box appears. In that we have to change. See, it's given width and height original. Original means already you are having an image, no? That image original width and height will be displayed, and you are going to add a new width and height to that image so that the size of the image can get reduced. So in new, near new, you can type the new size which you want the image to be edited, and then click OK. Okay, then your edited image will appear on your screen. This is called scaling. So can you understand, girl? Scaling is just reducing of the image without losing any part of the picture is known as scaling. And now we are going to see about grayscale images. So the image which appears in color is normally in color, we call it as color images. And here if they are in black and white, we call it as grayscale images. So they are composed of only shades of black color. Okay, not with all the colors, just only the shades of black. So how to do that? In effects option in the menu bar, we have to click effects option and then choose grayscale option, or directly you can press Ctrl plus G in the keyboard. See, here in menu bar you have to choose effects, then grayscale option, then your image will get converted like this. So before it was in color, and now after clicking grayscale, your image gets in shades of white and black. This is called grayscale images. And now we are going to see how to add text to an image. So if you are having an image and you want to add some text to it, see here, this is an image and we want to add a text called "I know how to keep you fit." So how we are going to do that, we can see. You have to click on the paste icon on the toolbar. It will be like a brush icon. Okay, we have to click that, and then a pop-up window like this will appear. In this we have to select the font, font size and style, font, how the letter font you want to be, can be any font, and the size, how the text should be appear in 10 or 13 or 14, you can select the size, and also you can select the style of your font. Then we have to click paste text. Okay, that icon we have to click. Then the type text appears in the middle of the image. Type text appears in the middle of the image. Now using the mouse, we can drag that to any places. Suppose if it is appeared here, then you can use your mouse and you can drag that text to anywhere within the picture. Then if you click a right click, or if you click enter icon in the keyboard, then the text will remain there. This is called adding text to an image. And then now we are going to add shapes to an image. So how to add shapes is, we have to choose either make selection or polygon selection button. Okay, then we have to select the area in the image where you want to insert a shape using the mouse. This is also similar like cropping. Like cropping also, you will use the same make selection icon. Here also you have to use that make selection icon, and you have to select the area, that is a required portion, where you want to insert a shape. Shape can be anything. It can be a square, rectangle or something, line or something. Which shape you want to insert, you can insert in that particular area. First we have to select it. Then we have to click the desired shape from the toolbar. Seeing this is the toolbar, these are some of the shapes available, and you can select any one image. If you select particularly this rectangle, means that rectangle shape will get filled in that area. This is called this is how we can add shapes to an image. And then we are getting into the process called smudging. So what is smudging? Smudging is that we can leave a blurred or smeared mark on the surface of the images. See here, in the first picture, you see a mom is going to running to catch her daughter. So now we can add a smudge effect for this girl. So to do that, see click smudge image icon on the toolbar. We can click. So after that, we have to drag and the mouse where you want to, for which part of the image you want that smudging to appear. See here, now here we have applied smudging, and see how it appears, like that a girl is running from there to here, that the part of this area is blurred and it is shown. This process, like this adding of effect, is known as smudging. Okay, so we have to click the smudge icon from the toolbar, then drag the cursor, the color in that area will get smudged or blurred. Now the image is full of life with the smudge effect. So there are many tools, flood fill, draw star lines, draw and fill shapes, with they are also like smudging only. Now we are going to see about the image file formats. See, always our image gets saved in GIF or JPG or PNG formats, or even in JPEG also. So most of the images are always saved in PNG for JPG format. So because it supports millions of colors, hence all the photographs or images are best saved in JPG format. So if the size of the image is very low, then we can save it in PNG formats. And zip files can save up to a maximum of 256 colors, because it's very, you can know zip files is always an animated files, so it's very smaller size, we can save it in that format. So always we have to use save as option to save the edited image. so that the original image will always be available. If you click save, then the original image will get edited. So if you have always we have to click save as option. Suppose I already told you before, if you take a copy of an image and then you start editing, then there is no problem. If you didn't take a copy and just you have started editing in an original image, then you have to click, instead of clicking save option, you have to click save as option, so that the original image is retained and the new, you can save that image in some other name. So for that you have to click only save as option. And now we are going to see about pixels. So what is pixel? A computer screen or an image, whatever it is, made up of several dots called pixels. Okay, they are the basic building block of a digital image, and each pixel has its own unique address, that is x and y coordinates. Each pixel has also the information which is supposed to display. So if the pixel quality is greater, then the image will be very sharper, it will be very clear. Okay, then we are going to see about resolution. Resolution is referred to as the number of pixels in an image, how many dots are present, that is known as the image, that is the number of pixel is referred to as image resolution. So resolution is always measured in width into height. Okay, so how to do that is, from the menu bar we have to select the scale canvas option. Now the dialog box appears and we have to change that, it is like similar to scaling. And we have to change the width and height of the image to change the resolution. So finally, after editing all these process, now we are going to print it. So how to print? You have to use print option in empty pane to print an image. So first we have to click file menu, then choose print, and we have to print option. So click file, then print, then we have to select a printer, then we have to select the size of the image. So here you can see the various size of an image. 640 into 480 means we have to get absolute largest pixels, which is the 4 into 6, and 1024 into 768 also 4 into 6. So these are the various image resolution and the printing size which is available, and we have to choose any of the desired size, and then we have to click the print preview button. What is meant by the print preview? Here you can see how your image gets printed. Okay, it will be displayed that. So we can see how our image gets printed. So then we have to click OK. If you are okay with that, then we have to click OK, and then the image gets printed. So once again we will have a glance. So how to open an empty paint? Just we have to click the start icon, then empty paint, then we have to choose file, and then click open to open any picture. So what is cropping? Cropping is removal of any specific or unwanted portion from the picture. So first we have to click the make selection icon and select the portion for which the images want to be retained, and then we have to click the crop option from the image menu. Then for scaling, we have to reduce the size of the image without losing any part of the image, is known as scaling. And for doing that, we have to click image option, and then we have to click scale canvas, and then select width and height. So you can change it and click OK. What is grayscale images? The black and white images are known as grayscale images. And then how to add text to an image? We have to click the paste text icon, then type the text where the text want to appears. Then you can change the location by using the mouse. Then how we will add shape to an image? First you have to select the area where the shapes want to appear. Then we can select any one of the shape icon from the toolbar, and then using the mouse, we can add a shape to it. What is called smudging? Smudging is the blood or a smeared mark on the surface of the images. How to add that? Just click on the smudge icon and drag with your mouse. You can drag the area where the smudging want to appear. Then what are the file formats? First always click save as option to save an image. There are GIF, JPG and PNG are the various file formats. So PNG uses only limited colors. 256 colors can be used in GIF formats. So what is pixel? Pixel, there are several dots that's appeared on a computer screen. What is resolution? The number of pixels in an image is referred to as resolution. What is printing? Printing is just you have to click print option in the empty pane to print an image. So thank you, and students, please learn all the topics, okay, carefully, and write and send it to me. Thank you.